Back on the island, Rey went and apologized to Luke, said she has disappointed Luke and how arrogant and entitled she acted. It's like she hadn't been appreciative of Luke's training. She thought she was able to defeat Kylo Ren without Luke's training back on Skykiller Base, but circumstances were in her favor only. She's been very frustrated waiting for answers since she was abandoned on Jakku. Rey is still mourning Han Solo's death. She has waited and actively sought for an answer, but to no avail. She no longer sees her lust and vengeance to kill Kylo Ren, but doing it to save Ben Solo's soul, as a respect to Han Solo's final mission. Luke accepts her apology. Luke told her he understands her frustration and longing for the truth, but he is glad she found the most important lesson that none of the Jedi of the Old Republic knew about, humility. It was the arrogance of the Jedi that let Darth Sidious take over when the Jedi were at their prime. Luke decides it is time to show the whole truth to her. Luke sent her mind to the Force plane to understand the cosmic force, and allowed her to see the visions of her purpose and origins. She saw snippets of Darth Vader's redemption arc. Rey snapped back to reality. Even the most horrifying monster can be redeemed in the past. Will history repeat itself? Now she believes that she's able to prove only using the light side of the Force she is as powerful as he is. She can prove to Kylo Ren he can do the same. After seeing her origins, Rey begged Luke not to abandon her because of her past. Luke promised Rey he will not leave her, as he once made a promise to who she was. Who she was in the past is not important. Who she is choosing to be is a significant part. The two embraced each other, like parent and child. Did Rey finally find her family that she's waited for? Luke explained, if Rey found out about the truth earlier, she would not have been able to resist the dark side's temptation, and would have fallen into it entirely. Then we have a flashback. When Luke escaped his Jedi temple, Maz explains that she has reprogrammed the homing beacon to instruct all Jedi to stay away from the Jedi temple. There is a First Order blockade in the system. It would be near impossible to leave. Luke placed the map in R2. Luke instructed Maz to go to Cloud City and find his lightsaber for safekeeping. Maz says her powers of the Force are not that strong, but she'll be able to sense and locate it. Luke prophesies the person with these two items will be able to be his apprentice, who will take down the First Order and the Knights of Ren by his side. Maz asked who that person will be. Luke responded, Maz will know when she meets that person. He told R2 to hide the map in any planet it first finds. Luke then programmed R2 to return back to Leia after hiding the map. He also timed R2 to shut down temporarily until the time is right. Back to the present, Luke tells her that it is time for them to go. Luke knighted Rey Skywalker as a knight of the new Jedi Order. Rey has been training for nearly decades now. It's only the Force on Octo that kept them from aging. Before they left the planet, Luke gave her his lightsaber. Rey will try and turn Ben back to the light, and Luke will help the Resistance escape. Chewie and Rey boarded the Millennium Falcon, while Luke pulled his X-Wing out of the ocean. He climbed into the X-Wing with R2 ready to rescue the Resistance. Back on the detention center in Mandalore, Holdo has another personal assistant, Rose Tycho. She sneaks into the prison cell and helps Poe and Finn escape. She also gave them Mandalorian armor as disguise. Rose has set the detention cell to explode as a diversion, but before they could regroup, they are confronted by Captain Phasma after the detention block has been blown up. They tried firing at Phasma, but her armor deflected her blaster bolts. Finn chose to sacrifice himself and fought against Phasma head-on, while Poe and Rose started a starship. Seeing Finn's bravery, it inspires Poe to feel confident again, and decides it's time to fight back. Phasma tells Finn how disappointed she was in him. The training Finn has received was broken by the lies of the Resistance and the Republic. The view of the First Order is misinformed. The First Order is a liberator. It segregated itself from the Republic and formed its own government. But the Republic just won't let them go, so they brainwashed First Order systems to become terrorists called the Resistance. In retaliation, the First Order defeats a giant tyrannical government that pretends to be a Republic. It frees billions of beings from tyrannical takeover disguised as democracy. Day after day, year after year, on thousands of worlds, people live their lives under First Order control without ever seeing a Star Destroyer or hearing a blaster fire from a stormtrooper. Finn tells Phasma that is all lies, and after his first mission deployed in Jakku, he knows that the First Order is a terrorist regime led by a warlord that disrupts peace. The Resistance is trying to free planets controlled by the First Order. They are not part of the Republic. The Republic is just a bystander trying to do the right thing and got decimated. Finn also pointed to the hypocrisy of Phasma's training. In becoming selfless to serve the First Order, he reveals how Starkiller Base was destroyed. She was the one who turned off the shields that turned the stormtrooper units she was leading against her. She shot them dead, but before she could fire at Finn, Finn smashed her blaster, and she took out a sonic baton. Finn and Phasma were evenly matched. While the two were fighting, the group was able to leave in a ship piloted by Poe. The two had a decent fight. Finn lands a heavy strike on Phasma's helmet, but he was worn down by Phasma. At this moment, Poe swoops in and saves him at the last second onto the ship. Rose tells the two that the rest of Mandalore are divided. However, she was able to gather some loyalists to fight First Order control. Poe got contact of Leia. They have local militia on their side, and was told to land on the other side of the planet where the Mandalore militia and resistance are preparing to battle against the First Order. They landed there just in time and barricaded themselves in an old Mandalorian base. In space aboard the Millennium Falcon, Rey used the escape pod to turn herself in to the First Order to turn Kylo Ren back to the light. Luke will regroup with the Resistance. Rey originally wants to come and help, but Luke tells her Kylo Ren's power comes from hating his former master. His appearance will only increase Kylo Ren's dark side power. Rey confronts Kylo and tries to turn him back, but Kylo told her it's too late. Rey asks if his father's efforts were in vain. A tear was seen dripping out of Kylo Ren's eye. Rey smiles warmly. Kylo brought Rey to the throne room. Snoke demands to know Luke's location. Rey responds, Luke Skywalker died of old age, and the only thing that was left was his lightsaber. Snoke laughed at her weak powers, trying to shield Skywalker from his mind reading. Snoke reveals he was the one responsible to connect Rey and Kylo Ren's mind together, and it was an attempt to show her the power of the dark side. How much a weak Ben Solo could achieve through the dark side. How much power she could possess through using the dark side. Snoke urged her to join the Knights of Ren. Make her mark in the galaxy as a hero of the First Order. Rey refused. The Snoke tormented her about her arrogance she once had. He also tried interrogating her on the whereabouts of Luke Skywalker. Rey refused to answer. Snoke's power is able to subdue Rey's. Trying to choke the answer out of her, Rey fights back but hesitates. She was worried if she loses control of her powers again, she will break her limbs or worse. But Rey is able to shield her mind from Snoke thanks to Luke's training. Snoke lifts Luke's lightsaber through the Force and pulls it close to his face. He inspects the weapon of the Jedi Master and chuckles. In a swift stroke of his hand, the handle implodes, and it shatters into pieces. The kyber crystal glows in a brilliant Viridian light. Snoke held his hand, and it floats to his palm. Snoke tells Rey she is in his mind game. There is no escape. Just like this crystal. Crushing the crystal with his hand, the jewel drops onto the ground. No longer glowing. No longer green. Just bleak grey. As if the life of the crystal has been sucked out. Angered by this, Rey reaches for Anakin's lightsaber, but Snoke uses the Force to strike the hilt at Rey's head. Through the Force, Qui-Gon Jinn's ghost tells Rey to have patience. Disobeying his teachings, Rey grabs Kylo Ren's lightsaber through the Force and ignites it. She runs to Snoke, and Qui-Gon tells her, "No!" Snoke throws her onto the ground as if Snoke was protected by an invisible shield. Kylo Ren's lightsaber slides back to him across the ground. Qui-Gon teaches her to use her knowledge and not her brute strength. Rey closes her eyes and kneels on her knees, as if in prayer. Believing she is weakened, Snoke probes into her mind. A trap is sprung. Now, Snoke is in her mind game. She showed him the vision that she had of her origins instead.